My dear Delilah, since last I wrote, I found myself a pair of sweet boots and what appears to be either a gerbil or hamster. The last time we were together, you may well remember I was not a zoologist, and you will be no doubt pleased to learn that much has not changed. As I am not a zoologist, I cannot, with certainty, my dear Delilah, tell you whether it is in fact a gerbil or a hamster, but I am fairly sure it's one of them. However, with certainty, I can say that it is the only companionship I've found since the death of Kevin. That said, you should not allow yourself to get jealous over my relationship with my new friend. It is, as I ask you to remind yourself, a small rodent. My dear Delilah, in the depths of the underworld, I just defeated a large yellow blob with ninja stars. If you're not impressed by this, I highly suggest you should be. My gerbil hamster, who I have decided to name Renfield, was rather impressed by my combat expertise. We both jumped up and down in celebration, and it was this whole big thing. My dear Delilah, while fleeing from a terrifying underground giant snake worm, I was once more crushed by a boulder. No one once warned me of the sheer frequency when in the wilderness of being crushed by boulders. Though I have become once more reincarnated, I find myself feeling sorry for Renfield, who has been left below. My dear Delilah, as I do not intend to give up my searching for you in the depths for at least another one or two episodes, I have redoubled my efforts into the underground. While doing so, I have discovered death, 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 and more death. Who could have possibly conceived that in the deepest, darkest depths of the world there would be such dangers? As such, in an attempt to reduce my contact with the dastardly, deadly forces of the depths, I have decided to build a tunnel. The tunnel is a direct drop from my underground burrow all the way to the lowest depths I have so far achieved. Some may argue that a tunnel that goes directly down instead of sideways is not a tunnel, but instead some sort of pit. I'm not, however, one to engage in such foolish conversations. I'm not a geologist, so the exact description of a tunnel does not concern me. And furthermore, I'm here to dig tunnels, not argue the dictionary. You may be worried, my dear Delilah, that dropping such depth is in some way dangerous to my health. Do not fret, however, my love. I have carefully constructed the tunnel above a small puddle. My dear Delilah, though my search for you and Renfield continues to be unfruitful, I have discovered a large glowing red heart. Uncertain of what it is, I decided to break it with my pickaxe and then eat it with my mouth. It tasted delicious and made me feel as spry as a young man aged 40. My dear Delilah, I found the place where I drowned the other day, but this time survived the encounter with it. Surely this means that I'm getting at least a little bit better at not becoming dead. To avoid ever falling down there again, I have drawn on my significant occupation health and safety experience and paved it over. My dear Delilah, while hoping to figuratively strike gold in my search for you, I have instead literally struck gold and found gold. Remembering that you like gold, I have made sure to stop and collect it. My dear Delilah, I have been slain, not only losing my life, but the gold too. I apologize for getting your hopes up over the prospect of gold. I suppose it's true what they say. All the gold in the world cannot protect you from vicious man-eating bats. However, hold hope, for as my journey to find you continues, the chances of finding gold remains. Until I write again, I shall continue to keep you in my heart, my dear Delilah.